गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ एस्ट्रोलॉजर अनिल अग्रवाल। टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस क्लस्टर ऑफ द सिक्स प्लैनेट्स इन कैप्रिकॉन इन द असेंडेंट ऑफ चाइना। सेवन प्लैनेट्स एक्टिवेट मार्स इन द सेवंथ हाउस ऑफ वॉर्स इन एज फार एज चाइना इज कंसर्न। यू नो दिस कंसंट्रेशन, चाइना हैज अ असेंडेंट ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन एंड दिस कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ प्लैनेट्स इन द असेंडेंट विल इन्फ्लुएंस China in a big way. The reason is very clear that seven planets will be influencing the seventh house of wars, battle and foreign relations, and Mars will be activating the natal Mars debilitated in the seventh house, and these six planets will be over the natal moon. So it is very simple, you know, it is very simple. The answer is very simple. The seventh house planets influencing the debilitated Mars in the seventh house and the natal moon in the ascendant, the seventh lord. Since the seventh lord is the relation with the foreign countries, wars, battle, there could be border clashes and brawl may take an ugly shape. As per the lunation chart, there is concentration in the third house of the borders as far as China is concerned, which clearly indicates brawl between the nations going for a toss. And the China, with China, maybe it is India, Taiwan, US or any other country for that purpose where China has border issues. The time frames have been discussed in my articles, and ammunition dump Mars when activates the sensitive points may be the most crucial time frame for this China going aggressive. Now, the difference on the 5th February 1962 and now on the 12th February 2021 is that Mars is not the graces, the Mars is not there. If Mars was there, then it could be a fierce battle. But since Mars is not involved, but Mars is aspecting Cancer sign, so Mars will, and it is in a square position, so the intensity reduces, but things will happen. You see, astrology is that we must use the proper methods, whether it happens or not, it's a different issue, but the methodology should be correct. So here, have a look of the formation chart. Formation chart of China. China is running the dasha of Mars Rahu, and Mercury Rahu, and Mercury is placed in the ninth house as the ninth lord, retrograde, combusted, and totally eclipsed by Ketu. Mercury is also the sixth lord, and in transit Mercury will be fallen in the Lagna, and Mercury is the sixth lord and fallen in the Lagna and as the ninth lord. So friends, China will be in an aggressive mood, and Mercury controls our psychology, and when Mercury is afflicted, then wrong decisions, there's so much concentration of planets in the ascendant which will influence China very much, and especially Saturn also there, Jupiter also there, Mercury, Venus, Sun, Moon. So friends, China has to be in an aggressive tone. The country in the operation, as I told, let us have a look of the signification of the two houses before we come to the conclusion. Ascendant, because the ascendant is influenced by six planets. The first house is the most important house because it represents the people and the general conditions of the country, public health, nation as a whole, their behavior in the time of emergency. So friends, the country will be influenced, right? At the time of emergency, national disaster, and ability of the nation to cope up with the national objectives. Malefic planets here are not good, whereas benefics are good and growth of the country. So by primarily the Lagna lord in Lagna and benefics, so it's showing a growth for the country. Jupiter will be debilitated, and Saturn on the 12th February 2021 and Dasha and Antar Dasha of Mercury will be in the ascendant in retrogression and will be also fallen state till 11th March 2021. Saturn as the ascendant lord in the Lagna will form Shasha Yoga, and Mars in the fourth house will form Ruchika Yoga. It's a great thing for China, for the rise in China, for prosperity. Hence, the influence will be also mixed and will have aggressive tendencies. Seventh house. The seventh house is wars, battles, open fire, enemies, foreign secret agents, international affairs, international disputes, relation with other countries, foreign affairs, death of secret agents, agreements, alliances, people who either violate the law of the land like anti-social elements or the persons who cooperate with the government. Have a look at the lunation chart. The concentration is taking place in the third house. So it's very obvious. Third house is house of borders. So border issues will erupt and China will be in an aggressive tone. The five limbs of the day, I've already discussed, they are not good. Especially on the 12th, the day is Thursday and the Lord is Jupiter in debilitation in the third house of borders. The day Lord Jupiter is placed in the Yama of Aquarius, Aquarius, the fourth house of the lunation chart, and the Yama Lord Saturn placed in the third house of borders in Vishagati at 12.23 degrees in own sign, in Vishagati. It's not good. The Yama Lord Saturn and the Lord of the third and the fourth house and the 8th and the 11th Lord Mercury were in retrogression and also fallen state is most malefic parameter for affliction to the third house of borders. The lunation chart and the Yama, the lunation moon and the Yama moon are in the sixth head and most malefic parameter for the good fructification in this fortnight. So friends, this is all. Just I wanted to share that China will be in an aggressive mode and it will with its wherever he has borders. So he will be in an aggressive mode. Please read my complete article for this. Thank you for listening to me, friends, and have a good day.